Guinea
snake.
Yay.
1, 2, 3.
Guinea snake.
This is a really complex undertaking. You know, we're messing around with a listed species, right? We've got to do it right. So I just wanted to make sure everybody understands that, yes, man, it is super cool that we're releasing this on the Nature Conservancy's property, but this is a very large undertaking with a whole lot of partners.
This year we released 26 individual snakes, roughly 11 females and 15 males. This is the largest number of snakes that we've released since we started the reintroduction out here at the Bluffs and Ravines Preserve.
Got 26 snakes here. They all have a pit tag, which is it's a non-transmitting identification tag that's inserted in them. We're verifying that those numbers align with what's in our spreadsheet here.
Suitable burrows have been flagged, and so we're just gonna try and find those, release a snake into it, and we'll record the GPS coordinates of the burrow and which snake went in there. And the snake's IDs are on the flagging, so try not to lose that before we release the snake.
I would like to think within, 3 years post-release, that's when they would start to be, I imagine they're already sexually mature and at the date of release, but
this guy's just gonna come out on it.
Finding a mate in a large landscape, especially being a zoo-raised animal, there's a little bit of acclimation that the snake needs to do before it even become part of reproductive part of the system. A lot of people, it took a whole lot of resources and dedication to even bring this habitat to the current condition that it's in. And it requires maintenance. It requires us to be out here stewarding the land, applying prescribed fire every 2 years so that this system continues to thrive and continues to be a place that can harbor eastern indigos.